invited to make a film at Hatra. The Iraq government was wanting to promote tourism. This was about 1979 or 1980. And there is this strange city of Hatra in the desert, in the Iraqi desert, which was organized, set up in Parthian times, sort of 3rd and 4th centuries AD, but then continued to be used by Arabs. And some of the earliest Arab inscriptions known are from the site. And so I read what was known about it, described in late classical authors and so on. And it was a wonderful visit. The filming was very successful. Again, it had a striking title, Lost Kings of the Desert, but it was very appropriate. And so we filmed in the Baghdad Museum, wonderful sculptures of King Sanatruk. They were all called Sanatruk. It was a dynastic name, some of which I think have been very sadly damaged in the looting, more recent looting in the Iraq Museum. And then everything seemed to go very well, and the representative of the Iraqi government said, would I care to go on a trip down to the south of Iraq, which would be laid on? So we had a car, and so I was able to go down and see Ur and Uruk and some of the great Sumerian sites, as well as to visit Babylon. That was all very educational. And then another program was made by a very enterprising director, BBC director Dominic Flessati, who was a very interesting man. And he wanted to work on the origins of the Bronze Age, the notion of the independent origins of the Bronze Age. And so we were able to go down to film in Bulgaria at the finds from the Varna Cemetery, which are really very interesting. It's the oldest gold work known in the world. And because of all this radiocarbon business, I'd be one of the first to realise that with the calibration, they had to be older, not only than Ur, but older than Troy, older than any other gold known, which is, I think, what they remain. And so, again, that poses problems about the origins of metallurgy. One has to relate in one's mind, I think, the early origins of metallurgy with the early origins of rich decoration. And the metal objects in question were prestige objects, the gold decorations, but also the copper axes were prestige objects before they ever became useful objects. And they didn't really become all that useful until alloying with tin was developed quite a lot later. And once they were tin bronze, they could be tougher and were more useful artifacts. So it was really the television filming there that opened the way to getting good photographs of the material and doing more work, which I subsequently did on the Varna finds. And I think the last of the programmes that I made before the Chronicle days ended was the Indus Valley civilization of Pakistan mainly and India. I think City of the Dead was the appropriate title there. But we were able to film Mohenjo-daro and Harappa, as well as visit a lot of places, visit a village where they still have traditional local potters using the potter's wheel and so on. And so out of that experience, I was able to learn a certain amount at first hand about the Indus Valley civilization. And in retrospect, I'm coming to feel more and more that comparative archaeology is very important. It's very difficult to be a specialist in more than one area. So at any rate, to be able to see seriously at first hand the products of these different civilizations is very important. It was on that 1967 visit to UCLA that I took the opportunity of making a first visit down to Mexico before leaving. And that was a wonderful experience to go to the great city of Teotihuacan for the first time, dating from about the 7th century AD, one of the most impressive archaeological sites I know, and to just get some glimpse of these astonishing civilizations there in Mexico. If one wants to have some insights into the human experience overall, just as to see the painted caves of France at a much earlier time, these are really very important experiences, I think. So I have to thank television for, at any rate, some of those.